Very good morning, students. Welcome back to my journaling class. We are discussing number 2, diversity in the living world. Under that, in previous part, we have discussed about Monera. Now, the next classification by the Whittaker made group of the organism is Protista. This is the next group we are going to discuss is Protista is another taxon which we are going to discuss. The Protista are the organisms which are consisting of the characteristic features of both the plants, animals as well as fungi. Understand? So if you observe the Protista group of the organisms, the Protista are these consisting of the characteristics of like animals, plants and fungi. So these actually Protista new taxon, but even though it's a separate taxon, it shows the characteristic features of animals, plants and fungi. Due to the presence of these common characteristics of the plants, animals and fungi, this Protista also called as the connecting link of plants, animals and fungi. So due to the presence of these characteristic features, allows the Protista to be considered as link in between plants, animals and fungi. Why it is called as connecting link? Because it consisting of the common characteristic features of the plants as well as animals and fungi. Due to this reason, these Protista are called as link. What they are called as? Link organisms of plants, animals and fungi. Now, what are the general characteristic features of the Protista that we will discuss? The common thing is, we know that the type of cell, that is cell type. How the cell? It is single cellular or multicellular, that is we are discussing. If you observe, these are found in unicellular like amoeba as well as in data, yeast also. Understand? These are the unicellular and also they consisting of the characteristic features of multicellular. These are acting like unicellular as well as a multicellular. Understand? Now, if you observe the multicellular line, giant kelp. This is an example of a multicellular. Understand? These, what type of cell do we have? They have single cell. So these are unicellular as well as multicellular. Understand? These are the unicellular and multicellular organisms. And cell wall. Whether they possess cell wall or not, the cell wall is present. Cell wall is present and this is made up of cellulose. The cell wall is made up of cellulose. Understand? That is another characteristic feature. And next, the presence or absence of the nucleus. Whether the nucleus is present or not. The nucleus is present. Nucleus is present. Due to the presence of nucleus, what they are called as eukaryotic organisms. What they are called? Eukaryotes. They are called eukaryotes. Understand? Next, membrane bound organelles present or not. So here the membrane bound organelles are present. They consisting of membrane bound organelles that also present in the Protista group of organisms. Next, respiration. What type of respiration do they carry? They used to carry out aerobic respiration
as well as the eukaryotic and aerobic
respiration. They used to carry out both the type of respirations, aerobic respiration as well as anaerobic respiration. Both are going to be carried out by protist group of organisms.
Now let us see the type of nutrition, how they will make their food, whether they are obtaining from other organisms or they were making their own food. That is you like to discuss, and these follows autotrophic mode of nutrition. These are the autotrophic
mode of nutrition can be followed.
At the same time, heterotrophic mode of nutrition also followed. Under autotrophic mode of nutrition, they follow photosynthesis.
Photosynthesis, the process where they carry out
for production of food. Under that example, let us take planktons. Planktons.
Where it is, the example is planktons.
And also we can take euglena also. Euglena also another example of
the photosynthetic protist.
And we can observe the euglena
are zooplanktons. Even though they are the characteristic features consisting of life animals, but they are behaving like the plants by the carrying out of photosynthesis. And why they are carrying photosynthesis means due to the presence of chlorophyll. They consisting of a chlorophyll that allows them to carry out their own food preparation. And what do we call that? Photosynthesis process. And they are called autotrophs. What they are called? Autotrophs.
Understand? And what is the next mode of nutrition is heterotrophs. Under heterotrophs, most of the protists are belonging to parasites. So what is the parasites means?
Obtaining from other organisms. They are taking the nutrients from other organisms without killing them. Understand? That is a parasitic mode of nutrition.
Under parasitic mode of nutrition, we can take trypanosoma.
So trypanosoma is one of the best example flagellated protist which is found in our body, and it causes sleeping sickness disease.
So what is the example of parasite is trypanosoma. And this trypanosoma causes sleeping sickness.
What is it? It causes sleeping sickness.
And next parasite we can take planaria. Planaria,
which causes malaria disease in our body. Understand?
These are the
nutrition modes. Understand?
So general characteristic features, and these are the most of them are aquatic. Proteins are the aquatic. Aquatic means they will be found in water, either fresh water or marine water. They will be found in either fresh water or marine water. Marine means the seas or ocean's water. That is salt water again. So aquatic in nature. These are proteins are aquatic in nature. They will be found in fresh water as well as marine water. And if you look at the characteristic features are they consisting of both the animals, plants as well as fungi characteristics. Due to the common characteristics found in proteins, they were called as links in between plants, animals and fungi. And general characteristic features we observe, they consisting of cell, as we know that they are made up of cell, and these cells are maybe either unicellular organisms or multicellular organisms, and they also consisting of cell wall, and this cell wall is made up of cellulose, and the nucleus is present. Due to the presence of nucleus, if any organism, they consisting of nucleus, what do they are called as? Eukaryotes. And they consisting of membrane bound organelles also. And they carry out respiration, either aerobic or anaerobic respiration. And the mode of nutrition, what is the mode of nutrition usually they carry is either autotrophic mode nutrition as well as heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Autotrophic mode of nutrition, as we know that they were making their own food. For that they follows photosynthesis. Under photosynthesis, we can take examples like planktons, zooplanktons, and the euglena. That is the, and in case of heterotrophic mode of nutrition, they are dependent directly or indirectly on other plants and animals. And the example, these under heterotrophic mode of nutrition, usually they follows the parasitic mode of nutrition. What mode they were following? Parasitic mode of nutrition. Under parasitic mode of nutrition, examples like trypanosoma, and which causes sleeping sickness. It is a parasitic flagellate which causes it is a parasitic flagellate, and that causes sleeping sickness. And another one is planaria, which causes malaria disease. Sorry, plasmodium. Malaria parasite Plasmodium, that causes malaria disease in human beings. So these are the some general characteristic features of the protist. And remaining we will continue in next part.